first thing we're going to do is clone the repository that has our data lake reference tech stack. And to do that, we're going to use this git clone command. We're going to put in this URL, github.com/minio-hq-data-lake-ref-arch. And that, again, that repository has the entire tech stack. It's all containerized, as we'll see in just a moment. Once that's done, we can then take a look at the README just to go over some quick system dependencies you'll want to be aware of and make sure you have installed on your system. So if we go into cd data lake ref arch, that's the folder that was just created through that git clone operation. And then we do a cat on the README or a bat on the README, depending what you what tool you have installed. You'll see at the very top, it says system dependencies and it lists Docker, Docker compose, MC, MC is the MinIO command line client, and JQ, which is a line for a library for parsing JSON files, or JSON output. So just make sure you have these installed. If you don't already, you can take a look at the URLs that are referenced here, and it'll give you operating system specific instructions on how to install those. Once that's done, we're going to go ahead and clear our console here. We can now spin up the Docker compose. Before we do that, let's just take a look at what is actually inside that Docker compose. And if we look at that, we will see that there are three services that we're interested in here, Dremio, MinIO server, and Nessie. And again, Dremio is going to be our web UI. We're going to use that to run SQL directly against the data lake. MinIO server is going to be our object store where we store our respective files. And Nessie is going to be our catalog. Let's go ahead and run docker compose up. We'll use the dash D flag, which indicates that we want to spin up in detached mode so it doesn't take over our terminal. We will now run docker compose logs dash F, which will allow us to follow the logs. And we're simply doing that as a way to make sure that everything's coming up as we expect, and so that we will actually know when the stack is completely bootstrapped and running on our machine. We see a indication just a few seconds later, Dremio daemon started as master. That is a sign that in fact, we're good to go. And now we can control C. And just to prove that we are in fact running those three containers, we can, if we'd like, say docker container ls, and we will see in fact, three containers are running, Nessie, MinIO, and Dremio. Okay. The next thing we're gonna do is run a shell script. And this particular shell script is going to create an initial user. It's going to create that user in Dremio. It's going to give them admin permissions. It's also going to do some of the configuration to set up Dremio, Nessie, and MinIO so that they all point to each other. Of course, this could all be done easily through the web UI, but that would take a few extra minutes. It's not necessarily the point of this session. So we're just going to give you this super convenient shell script, which does it for you. And you'll see creating first user in Dremio, first user created, and finally at the very bottom, we'll see lab initialization complete. The next step we want to do is create an alias. So we're going to use the MC command line tool. We're going to run this command over here. And effectively what that does is it says alias set, so create an alias, called MinIO1, and MinIO1 is going to map to this URL, localhost 9050, which is where that service is running in Docker. And then it's going to use these credentials. So anytime you see MinIO1 in a subsequent MC command, just realize that that is a reference to this alias that we set. We can now easily create our bucket. And we're going to again use the command line to do that. MCMB stands for make bucket. And we're calling our bucket warehouse. Why are we calling it warehouse? Because this particular guided exercise is simulating the usage of a data lake as a supplementary data warehouse. We're doing analytics, we're storing structured data. So that's why we're choosing to call it warehouse in this case. We can now move over to our browser. If we go to localhost 9053, we will see a username and a password. The username is admin, all lowercase, and then again, all lowercase, bad for the number four, admins with an S at the end. This is what our shell script set up for us. So as long as you use that, you should have the exact same username and password. Obviously not production grade. We're now inside Dremio. Let's switch over to the SQL runner tab over here on the far left. We're not going to go too deep into Dremio today. We're going to just stick to basic SQL. So let's go to SQL runner. And we're going to collapse this particular session over here on the left to give us a little more real estate. We now have the ability to execute SQL against our data lake.